Welcome to Tito's Salon. This episode we invite Professor Mara, the professor of Moscow State University, to be our distinguished guest. Hi, Professor Mara.
First of all, nice to meet you from Moscow, and we are working at home. Even it's our working places are open, but still we stay at home and work at home, continue our work in summer. I'm a leading researcher from Institute of Mechanics of Moscow State University. The Moscow State University, or Lomonosov Moscow State University, is the biggest and most important university of the country, most famous university all around the world from Russia. And I am working in a research institute, which is a part of academic and the science program of Moscow State University, and mostly I am working in mathematical modeling. Mathematical modeling different objects like resisting media and dry friction effects and so on. So we work with some robotic systems, mechatronic systems, wind engineering, and so on.
Okay, I see. Because I saw you were specialized in the article mechanics, so I think today is the right person to speak about the machine tool industry. So now let's talk about machine tool in Russia. We know that machine tool can be used in many industries like automotive, aerospace, defense, and more.
So, Professor Mara, for Russia, what industry is the machine tool used mostly? Of course, the most important industry in Russia, first of all, is military. Military complex is military industrial complex, and kind of electricity, nuclear power, and of course, kind of different kind of gas, and automotive. We have two most famous factories in Russia for automotive vehicles, train vehicles, and so on.
So, how much machine tool imported or make in Russia?
Unfortunately, 20% of machine tools machines, machine tool machines are imported. Made in Russia are growing. In 2018, it was most successful year for Russian production. Only 65% of machine tools were imported. But in 2019, situation was worse due to economical crisis. This economical crisis, you know, in Russia, we live under sanctions from the United States and Europe. This year, of course, is much it's different, and I don't know what will be in the end of the year.
Yeah, I see. So, other industry and professions you mentioned affected by the pandemic?
Sure. According to reports of our government, Ministry of Trade and Industry, or Ministry or Central Bank, is expected that in this year and of course next year, import of metal working machine will decrease. Decrease to level maybe 2 years ago. And of course, it is associated with sequences of the coronavirus pandemic.
I see.
This is the most problem, of course. So, and since machine tools are expensive equipment, for them will recover more slowly than for other types of equipment and the goods. So our government expected a growth maybe in 2024.
Okay. I see. So from what you are saying, so there have been a government policy change for the machine tool in poor conditions?
Not much action of government, but we have national program for decreasing import dependencies, and government tried to spend a lot of money and start a new programs for support, especially support industry to the products all around the world. Unfortunately, this program is not started yet, so it's not so active. But government promised that they will break walls between this money they provided and consumers. I mean, producers, manufacturers, and factories, and so on.
Okay, I see. So also we can see the COVID-19 hit the global supply chain really hard, including China, Europe, and the US. And also the pandemic has severely implications for international production and might leave legacy for years to come. Could you share us your insight of supply chain disruption and its implications to Russia and global market?
You know that mostly we bought machine tools and especially metal working machine tools from China. Last year, China 36% of total Russian market of machine tools.
Wow.
And Taiwan also is very active, actually is number two, and it was estimated as 11% Taiwan machine tools in Russian market. As I said before, that we expect that their market will decrease very much.
Okay. So this year and next year,
Sure.
Okay, I see. So what's the current status of return to work for manufacturing safety in Russia?
If we say about Russia, so in Russian mostly of Russian big factories, especially factories that produce machine tools. You know, Russia produces big machine tools, expensive one, mm-hmm. and machining centers, small size machine tools, and robotics is very difficult mm-hmm. because China cheap, and quality of production is enough for small manufacturers in Russia.
Mm-hmm.
So these big factories continued working even during March, April, and May, the most difficult time in our country.
Mm-hmm.
They just maybe make some restrictions for workers, but workers visited the working places mm-hmm. and continue work. So for Russian industries, not so many pandemic. The most influenced it is automotive vehicles production and jewelry production. So this maybe decreases 10% in March mostly, but food, for example, food producers and chemical production, you know, mm-hmm. they even grow. And the medium like electricity and the military, they almost no difference. To say what is the real
mm-hmm.
problem is a total economic crisis or problem with pandemic.
So those two problems just be mixed together. We cannot tell which one to impact your industry, right? Okay, so let's move on to machine tool after sales service. So since the pandemic just outbreak, so what if the mechanics or engineer or machine tool suppliers couldn't go outside for product deliverability, testing, and after sales service? How do your local company cope with this issue? We've heard there are some companies use the webcam to demonstrate to their customers. So how about in Russia?
This is a very interesting question. You know, the growing of internet capacities and speed, and you know, we can communicate now this interview without any delay. At least 5 years ago, it was already started practice where most production imported
mm-hmm.
from China. So these Chinese companies, they organize online consulting for our engineers.
Mm-hmm.
And it works already, you know, it worked before pandemic, of course it works now.
Mm-hmm.
And getting be more and more popular, so we can show some details in an increasing video, so online, and very, very convenient and fast. The only problem is a language problem.
Oh, okay. I see.
So engineers who knows Chinese,
mm-hmm.
at least English, the salary grows very fast.
Mm-hmm.
And just 1 week ago, I saw this kind of communication between Russian engineers and American engineers.
Mm-hmm. And let's move on to Let's Since this program is for Teams, have you ever been to Teams? If yes, what's your impression about
Teams? So, in my opinion, Teams is an excellent example of organizing an exhibition at the highest level. Really, I visited Teams last March, I mean March 2019, And I was surprised. So how big and how good this exhibition? 1,000 participants, several thousand visitors from different countries. So Taiwan is very good, especially TITRA is very good in organizing international exhibitions and the conference.
Thank you. We welcome you come next year. Our teachers will host again next year in March. We will invite professor to come again.
I will come. Exactly. No doubt.
Okay.
I'm just waiting when the border is open.
Okay. So let's wrap up. Thank you, Professor Malat. I enjoyed talking with you. And thank you for your sharing and your time. So just stay tuned, everyone. We'll see you next time in Thai Tito Salon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.